cold outside.
I've got the month of May.
I guess you say,
but can make me feel this way.
My girl, my girl,
my girl,
talking about my girl,
my girl.
Ooh. Ooh. When I think of Motown, I think of the greatest artist that ever walk the face of the planet.
Yeah.
You talk about Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
You talk about Diana Ross.
Yeah.
The Supremes and Marvin Gaye. And
Stevie Wonder.
The Temptations were gods.
Martha Reeves and the Vandellas.
Gladys Knight.
Lionel Richie.
The Four Tops.
Rick James.
The original Super Freak.
The Jackson Five.
Smokey Robinson. Oh, God. Quit.
I'd be here all day, man.
Oh,
Motown really is the soundtrack of your life.
Say what can make me feel this way.
My girl.
My girl.
I mean, that was it.
Really successful in the music business when he decided to move to LA, and he was still a dreamer. He arrived in Hollywood and began to produce movies and television, and many of us got to share in that dream.
I was a dreamer. I just felt there was no limit to what people can do or where they can go. I wanted to evolve into something more than just a record man or even a music man.
Love you.
We had scaled, record-wise, as many mountains as you were going to scale, and we were continuing to do that. But the point was, it was now time to go past that. You could not be in the television production business out of Detroit.
I think when Motown moved to Los Angeles, the people in Detroit were really very disappointed to see them go. But I knew, in terms of what he was trying to do, he had to leave Detroit, and he had to do what they did.
He said, I want to become an entertainment complex. I want to do movies and TV and all this. He said, we could stay here and be a record company forever. He said, but we don't have the access to these other medias that I want to become involved in. So he said, so you might as well pack.
During the 60s, when I was doing Julia, there were no black television producers. So his concept of moving into television, at first I thought that was a door he was never going to be able to knock that door down.
The networks always resist anything that they haven't seen before. I mean, it's a Me Too business now. You know, if something worked once, let's do it too much. Well, there was resistance to anyone they hadn't worked with. And Barry they hadn't worked with, one. And two, he was music, which had nothing to do with television. He represented artists.
I don't think Barry Gordy went into television because there was a ceiling on opportunity or anything. Barry is an entrepreneur. He's a businessman. I mean, he loves to do it all. And he has his hands in all of it. So if he's going to do a television show, why wouldn't he do it?
TCB, starring Diana Ross and the Supremes with the Temptations.
Thanks to each and every one. You are dreams.
No, Diana, we're the Temptations.
All the formalities are done now. Let's loosen it up and have some fun now. Ladies, it's time for you to do your thing.
It just broadened our perspective of what the Temps and the Supremes were about, because we were doing songs that were out of the norm for us. We weren't just doing, you know, what the Temps were noted for. We were doing I can't think of the very popular tune at the time.
Do you know the way to San Jose? I'm going back to find some peace of mind in San Jose.
G.I.T. on Broadway.
I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way.
Tootum tom tom.
Fulfill my dreams. I wanted Broadway. I wanted movies. I wanted television. And I wanted everything for myself and for the artist that I was responsible for.
Barry Gordy has always been amazing in his ability to do like 18 things at one time. The fact that he was doing a movie and television had nothing to do with the fact that he was still running Motown Records.
Yes, I got my plane ticket.
Michigan mom who went from the kitchen to the seat of a jet fighter. Plus, how a local judge could be in hot water after a Target 7 investigation. Watch tonight, Action News at 11, where 7 stands for news.
I need love, in my mind. I need to find someone to call mine. But mama said you can't hurry love. No, you just have to wait.
She said love don't come easy. It's a game of give and take.
Whatever Motown means, as a rags-to-riches story, as a company that cultivates talent, it really flows through Diana Ross and her life and her rise. She is, you know, she's the epitome, the exemplar of what Motown accomplished in terms of grooming, dressing, working with how to speak, what to say, what not to say, how to move on stage, how not to move on stage, where to look, where not to look, shaping songs around the persona of the artist.
And here she is, the one and only, the unforgettable. Hey, what was your name?
You got a smile so bright.
When you think of the word diva, that's the first person that people think of is Diana. She had magic about her. She made people feel good. She could smile and people wanted to smile back. And when you have that, when you got that certain something, it's like gold.
She wanted to be a star, and she knew I wanted to make her a star. The relationship we had was one that, you know, you love your star. I loved my star. I didn't want her to sacrifice anything to be with me. I wanted her to get what she wanted, who she was. You know, what she was meant to be. She was meant to be something here on this earth, and I wanted her to get that.
There was this relationship between Barry and I that was, it was such a bond. I used to say that if he thought I could do it, I could do whatever he believed I could do, I could do it. I would do it because he thought I could do it. Because he believed that I could do it, I would do it.
If you do have a group, and if you have a member of that group who can step out and be a worldwide star, you can't keep them back. With Diana Ross, she's a star of the first magnitude. There's no way that one can limit them, that individual star, and say you're only into music. If you have talent to become a star in a different arena.
I left the Supremes to pursue my acting career. Barry Gordy and my mother believed in me, and because of that belief, and because of that trust, I felt like I could move mountains. The most central figure in Barry's approach to Hollywood was Diana Ross. I believe that he believed that together they could knock down the barriers to anything.
I was from Detroit, a black record company owner from Detroit who came out to do my first film. And of course, I was just extremely excited about making this film with Diana Ross.
I watched Barry Gordy create with and for Diana Ross, something that I had never been exposed to before, and something the industry had never been exposed to before.
If I should take a notion to jump into the ocean.
I don't think that I would have ever had an opportunity to play that character if it had not been for Barry Gordy. He had all of these ideas, and he was able to implement these ideas pretty much by himself. I'm not quite sure this Tom was really ready for all of that with this little brown-skinned man. But I found out one thing, that money's more important than racial differences in the color of a person's skin.